the insane do not know they are. This is a lesson on how to think. Because they live their whole lives in an imaginary and artificial reality world. To you and them, they will appear perfectly sane. But you are about to learn what is insanity and how it is possible for some people to live their whole lives completely insane. The insane have these characteristics. They always easily exhibit hate, anger, aggression, violence, evil, no compassion, greed, complete selfishness and a willingness to do harm. They will most often exhibit amazingly beautiful and likable exterior personalities. But the insane are only concerned about their exterior appearance, and when they communicate with others, they only look to and respond to your reactions. The insane live only for your reaction. For the insane never look inwardly. You might appreciate reading my earlier article entitled, There is No Reasoning with the Insane. That is because every time or any time they ever attempt to look inwardly, they get really scared. For they get lost in the expanse of the darkness of their souls. So they immediately look back to their exterior appearance. The mere idea that an insane person might be made to look inwardly when in conversation with a very sane human will truly bring out their hate. The more the sane person tries to make the insane one look inwardly, the more violent the insane will become. But the problem is also with the sane person not knowing what insanity is and how to easily recognize it. It is very easy to recognize insanity. Just try to get any truth from the insane and you will not be able to. No matter how trivial the truth may be. Also, please realize that the truly insane have no limits to their insanity. They will always hide their insanity by the beautiful exterior image they will present to you. They will even kill you if you are a strong intellectual of honest and truthful values. But the insane will do it slowly, discreetly, and in the shadows. Be it first by slandering you, backstabbing, spreading falsehoods, making accusations, etc., etc. If that fails to satisfy the insane, then their hate will make them kill you. And most times the killing will be planned out so they, the insane killers, never get caught. Which is how all covert agents operate. But hey, I will now get back to more details as to what the insane are like, and later I will give the really simple truth of what is sanity and what is insanity. That explanation will truly enlighten you. I will also write in a way that will also enlighten the frightened people who know they have some mental problems but have been completely unable to understand how to easily overcome their insanity. Many insane people who try to look inwardly get confused and lost. Some will choose never to return to where their minds were previously. That being the reactionary person they were. Those insane know and do not like what they looked like when they looked inwardly. But they try and keep trying to look inwardly to try and help themselves. They will very often turn to the so-called mental health professionals for help. Only to be further convinced by the quacks that they truly are insane. At which point some will completely lose their minds and have to be committed to a psychiatric institution and be put in the ward for the completely insane. The quacks will very polite at telling you that you are mentally ill. The quacks have created their very own dictionary of psychiatric words to convince you that you are insane and need the quacks medicine. Please read my two other related articles about psychiatry. So who is delusional now? And psychiatry industry of death. Those that know they are being insane and go to the quacks hospitals will never recover. They will be medicated to the death of their minds and most often their bodies. Others will go right into the dark depths of insanity where not them or anyone else will ever be able to bring them out into reality. Every quack knows that to try to go reach into the totally insane person's minds to help them find their way back out will be a trap that would make the most sane human also go insane. I therefore warn you to never go into their minds and to never try to understand the inner workings of the insane mind. Quacks, the government establishment, schools or social engineers never ever teach anyone how to think. They are only concerned about physiologically conditioning you on what to think, which amounts to brainwashing. What you need to do whether you are sane, mildly insane or possibly truly insane is to understand and know the definitions of insanity. Insanity is an absolute. That absolute leads to a complete loss of any logical direction. Whereas sanity is the other absolute. That absolute is guided by self-control direction. I will now ask you a question that I have always asked people I am in conversations with. I have never met anyone that could answer it. The answer is so very simple, but due to social engineering, you and everyone else has never ever been taught these simple and empowering truths. So here goes. But I have already answered this in my text up above. But I will ask the question now. Truth is absolute. So what is the one word that is absolutely the opposite of truth? No one ever answers insanity. For they often do not even understand what truth is. They have been led to believe that truth is, someone's opinion is subject to one's ideas, objectivity, or is relative to one issue. People cannot understand the purity of truth. The purity is that truth is an action and can only exist if you always seek and speak the truth, or at minimum say nothing. Truth can only exist if you act on it, and truth will cease to exist when you cease to seek it and speak it. Truth is an action, and insanity is a complete lack of action. Which is why the insane only react. A note I would like to add here is that an activist is always one that seeks truth and then exposes the truth. For without activists, we on this planet is doomed to what the insane will do if the activists do not fight for truth. I believe that even the so-called and socially accepted little white lie is an early sign of insanity. I was once recently told by a young lady that everyone lies and that it is impossible to live your life by always telling the truth. She got really mad when she told me this. I responded to her that she was wrong. I tried to explain to her that it is very easy to live your life by truth. For truth is an action, and that all it takes to do it is to have self-control. But she had no self-control, which is why she became so violently opposed to the idea that it is possible to be always truthful. Another point to this lesson I would like to mention is that truth is always blindingly very simple. The light of truth will always blind those that live in the darkness of insanity. And that, it is always lies, deceptions and self-deceptions that are endlessly complicated. If you have so far understood this lesson on how to think, then you will be in a direction for truth. Then and only then will you fulfill yourself as a human. For humans need to love and be loved to fulfill their lives. You need to realize that love can never exist in the absence of truth. So I hope that my lesson will bring you to the amazing point of actually loving truth. And when you do, you will be amazed as to how beautiful your reality will become. You will one day discover pure truth, which is where God awaits you to communicate with His pure spirit of truth. Also, please realize that love is what fulfills a human soul, but can and will never exist without pure truth. If you seek pure truth, God of heaven will be with you. People get so confused and think that God can only be found or realized in a religion. Which is why I previously wrote the article, God is not religious. People who know not how to think cannot understand the simplest truth. The truth that God truly exists. Do you want proof? You will never know the truth if you do not seek it. The first lesson is to realize that you cannot assume to know what truth is, nor can you put conditions or limitations on truth. You have to blindly seek it. For the light of truth will always feel and seem blinding. When this occurs for the first time, the light of truth enters into the dead of the darkness of ignorance and stupidity, it truly will be blinding. So try this. Pray to God, but remember your prayer must always be completely truthful and sincere. You will soon know the truth for yourself. Please read this below. I believe it will help you on your way. Oh, and remember that Jesus never went to church, nor did he ever preach anything but God. Christian religions never existed until more than 500 years after they tried to kill Jesus. Jesus was a hippie and the world's first recognized activist. Jesus never asked us to follow him. He only wanted you do as he did. He was an example for us all. But the insane, as usual, could only exhibit hate and they tried to kill him. But the spirit of God, truth, can never be killed. Only the insane could ever believe that truth can be killed. Ask yourself now. Would you allow Jesus to be killed again if you discovered that Jesus truly is here now? Will you continue to allow the insane to guide us and this planet to oblivion, or will you finally take control of your minds and actions by finally seeking and speaking only truth? So here is the beginning of my poem. I am in love and I am so happy I did it. I found my soulmate. It's amazing, my soulmate is so beautiful and perfect. I can count on my soulmate to never deceive me or send me in the wrong direction. My soulmate is always there for me. We always get along because we are in pure love. Our love works because it is based on truth. For without truth, our relationship would be doomed. We are never selfish, for we always give of ourselves. In troubled times I confide with my soulmate for support. I tell my soulmate my deepest secrets and weaknesses. I don't fear exposing my innermost frailties to my soulmate. It's so amazing what strength can be gained from sharing pure love. Love makes me feel so good that I now can see beauty all around me. I see it in the flowers and the bees. I see it all around me in nature. I see beauty even in the worst of storms. I see it in other people who are in love. Before I fell in love with my soulmate, I walked around and could never see the beauty all around me. I am in love and I am so happy. This pure love is so strong that I now have enough love to give even to the sorriest of souls. Love is so contagious. Once I got pure love in my life, I was strengthened so that I could now share some of it with those around me who have never felt pure love before. This pure love in my life has humbled me so. I could have never found my soulmate if I had not always sought truth and always spoke the truth I discovered. I have been completed as a human with this pure love. I love truth, for without it I would always be lost and deceived. The more my love grows, the more beautiful my soulmate becomes, for love is in the eye of the beholder. I know that my soulmate will always forgive me if I am always willing to face and admit the truth of my wrongdoings. My soulmate will always know if I am not being truthful to myself. There can never be a pure love in my heart if I am not always truthful to myself. For my soulmate's pure love could never reach me if I am not pure in truth. I am in love and I am so happy. I love you, God, for you are the truth and my soulmate. End of poem. Another afterthought for you. God wants all his children to be born of love and not lust. For God gave us life from his love. And that is the truth. I am the child of God. We all are. You need to know how to think to come to that realization. Written by Truth Soldier. The insane do not know they are. This is a